This is an original French lithograph poster from 1905 showing the Crotton brothers performing feats of strength. This poster was torn and ripped and in poor condition, and we gave it a poster fix. Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome to Poster Fix. Linen backing is an ideal way of flattening out a poster that has heavy creased folio folds. When we got this poster, it was folded, creased, it was ripped in the folds. It had some rips at the corners and paper chunks missing here and there. This lithograph was sent to us by the grandson of one of the men who appear in this poster. And as I look at the back, I can see this old dried up tape, and I can feel that it's very hard and stubborn. It won't come off easily without solvent.
That tape is like cement on that. Boy, there's massive rips here in the folds. Breaks everywhere at every intersection. It's very delicate, but this lithography is stunning. It's got these fights in it. It's beautiful. Tableaus, as it were. The original Crotton brothers. Apparently there's a very old rip here. Back in the day, before the poster was ripped throughout, there was only one rip in it. Someone attempted to repair it with this old Scotch tape, but now the tape is hardened, yellow, and I've got to get it off there. I might soak it with some naphtha now. I'm trying to decide something. These rips go almost to the center. There's only 3 inches here that's attached, and then there's the rip that goes down there also. So I'm thinking of just splitting it in half. It'll make it easier and less risky to linen back. But it's also ripped here, a good deal of this. So I don't know, do I want to put it up in halves, quarters, or as one whole sheet? For now, I'm going to take off the tape, and then I'm going to let the tape soak. I'm going to let this tape soak in naphtha while I prepare a screen with acid-free paper and canvas. Yeah, lighter fluid. Lighter fluid is just about the best thing. It's a weak solvent. It's naphtha, which is similar to benzene. It's about the weakest solvent you can get, but it's stronger than turpentine and stronger than mineral spirits. So I'm going to apply this here and then let it soak for a while, and hopefully that will loosen the glues. It may or it may not, because old tape sometimes doesn't respond, or at least it doesn't respond right away. I'm going to put some weights on this so the naphtha can soak.
If you like Poster Fix videos, be sure to show it by hitting the like button, and being sure that you're a subscriber. Hit the subscribe button. And once you do that, hit the notification bell to make sure that YouTube informs you of whenever we upload a new video, which is about weekly, sometimes more than once a week. So we've been letting this Crotton Brothers lithograph soak in the naphtha for several minutes to see if we can loosen up the tape. And it does seem to have done that. Now I have to carefully go in there with a spatula and lift up the tape. And once I've done that, I've got to scrape off the tape residue that's been left there. I'm laughing to myself because this is probably the oldest rip on the poster. This clean rip probably happened when the poster was in much, much better condition. And then someone put tape on it to hold the piece there and to prevent it from getting worse.
Scraping the excess residue off the paper.
Nothing is really missing from the paper, and it's lasted all this time, so I have to say that the tape did its job, but it did stain the back of the paper. It did not stain the front of the paper, thank goodness, so I won't have to worry about touching up the stain on the front.
We've got this screen stretched with cotton canvas, and now
the acid-free paper! This is the acid-free paper which will get mounted to that screen.
I'm taking this acid-free wheat paste and I'm going to cover it all over the paper, good and wet, every spot. No dry spots are allowed. And once the paper is good and covered with this acid-free wheat paste, I will pick up the paper and lay it down onto
the screen, placing it appropriately and trying to push out any abnormalities. Then I have to take a few sponges and wipe off the table of all that wheat paste that's lying around the edges.
A feat of strength, the lifting of the screen.
Place it down onto the table.
I refer to this size screen as S2, that means small number two. And that is because back in the day, back before I moved to Navy Yard, I had another screen size called S1, and S1 was a little bit smaller. S1 was a little bit smaller than the S2, but I discontinued using it, but I keep the same name just out of a sense of continuity. The excess paper here, which I'm cutting off so that I can create a nice lid. Now I'm pushing out the air pockets and making sure that the paper is expanding as well as hugging the canvas, pushing out the excess wheat paste and air pockets.
Okay, the screen is ready to have the poster mounted to it. And you will see this poster get mounted to that screen after this commercial break, so don't go away.
Well, we're back at the Poster Fix shop, and we're just about ready now to linen back this poster.
So I'm going to lay the poster down onto this dry screen, onto the paper, fold it in half, and I'm going to apply wheat paste to the area where there is no poster, directly to the acid-free paper. And I've got to make sure that I cover it good and well and make sure there are no little bumps and sometimes little specks of dried gunk get in there, and I have to get them out so that there are no paste bumps.
And now I'm going to flip this side down onto the wheat paste that I've applied to the acid-free paper. I'm trying to minimize the amount of times I open this poster up, as you can probably witness.
Well, this poster shows the Crotton brothers. Otto Arco began his vaudeville career with an old family friend, Emil von Magyarossi, as the duo, the Crotton brothers, as seen on this beautiful French poster. What was their act comprised of? The Strongmen. In this case, the Strongmen. They performed feats of strength, muscle control, and hand balancing, dressed as Roman gladiators. In the 19th century, the term strongman referred to an exhibitor of strength or similar circus performers who performed feats of strength. More recently, strength athletics, also known as strongman competitions, have grown in popularity. These competitions are now composed of a variety of events in which competitors have to move the highest weights possible, the winner being the one having the highest tally across all events. In the past, strongmen would perform various feats of strength such as the bent press, not to be confused with the bench press,
continue to subtly stretch it with my left hand as I'm pulling out the excess wheat paste and air bubbles with my right hand. It's probably more of information than you need, but I presume you watch these videos for knowledge. Anyway, this poster, the bottom half of this poster is stretched out pretty well. I'm expecting the top half to be a little harder because there's more breaks in it. However, I'm
happy with how the bottom half is stretched out. It looks really good.
They needed to have large amounts of wrist, hand, and tendon strength for these feats, as well as prodigious oblique strength. In the late 20th century, the term strongman evolved to describe one who competes in strength athletics. The Crotton brothers, as seen on this beautiful French poster. Eventually, Von Mogyorossi got married and left the group, but Arco's own brother Peter stepped in to replace Emile. The Arco brothers would go on to perform in the Folies Bergère in Paris, the Hippodrome in London, etc. Emile got married. The customer who sent us this poster is the grandson of Emile. And he writes to me, he says, born Emile von Mogyorossi in Gyula, Hungary in 1880, Emile took up bodybuilding instead of managing his family's estate. He joined with Otto Arco in performing feats of strength and hand balancing while traveling with various circuses as the Crotton brothers. Meanwhile, my grandmother, Louise Skremka, and her sister Mignon had a trapeze act as the Skremka sisters. The two acts crossed paths, and Emile married Louise in 1912 and started their own act as Crotton and Skremka. They performed worldwide, but mostly in New Zealand and Australia. My mother Louise was born in 1913. In 1915, my grandmother left Australia with my mother and moved to New York. Emile remained in Australia and was lost track of. My grandmother never spoke about him, ever.
I have to be careful with how I wipe this down. There's a lot of wheat paste on the face that I have to get off, but there's also a lot of paper curls, rips that I have to be careful not to exacerbate or aggravate, make worse.
I found a note in an old scrapbook of my grandmother that read, Emile died 1955 in Orange, Australia. However, they have no record of it when I checked with them. That is from the customer who sent us this poster, the grandson of Emile, who appears on this poster with his partner, Otto, of the Crotton brothers, the strong men who went around the world performing feats of strength. This is a beautiful example of French lithography from that period. Not only is it a rare poster, but this poster is the only artifact that he has to remember his grandfather by, so that gives some special meaning to this assignment of restoring this poster. This poster is printed in lithography. Most likely the plates were either stone or zinc, and the artist worked directly on the plates. It resembles, in design, a lot of the posters printed in the Belle Époque, or the 1890s. That's why I almost thought it was an earlier. I've seen similar kinds of posters promoting gas lamps and electric lights that are designed this way. Most likely the plates were either stone or zinc.
Let's see if I can peel off that piece later after it's sitting, drying. If not, I'll deal with it after when I restore it in a few days.
I think this lithograph looks clean now. I've gotten all the wheat paste off of it. I'm marveling, since it's wet, it looks dark. It makes the colors look even richer, but the colors are very rich. There's no fading in this old lithograph at all. It'll look really handsome when it's finished.
Well, we're going to let this screen dry for a few days before we commence with the restoration, and then trim it down and complete it with the final retouching. You'll see all that after this commercial break, so don't go away.
Well, we're back in the poster fix shop, and we are in the next stage of restoring this vintage poster.
And now where the paper is missing paper, we're using a substance that I call paper pulp as a fill. Paper pulp is made of a powder of acid-free paper mixed with methyl cellulose and another agent. And once we've used it to fill in these holes, we'll go in there and sand it. There are ridges in the poster, still, even after linen backing it. Ridges caused by either the fold creases or rips. This burnishing will help flatten those ridges, and I must do it before I do the touch-up. Posters printed in lithography. What is lithography? From the ancient Greek, lithos means stone, and graphene means to write. Lithography is a method of printing originally based on the immiscibility of oil and water. The printing is from a stone, lithographic limestone, or a metal plate with a smooth surface. It was invented in 1796 by German author and actor Alois Senefelder as a cheap method of publishing theatrical works. Lithography can be used to print text or artwork onto paper and other suitable material. Lithography originally used an image drawn with oil, fat, or wax onto the surface of a smooth, level lithographic limestone plate. The stone was then treated with a mixture of acid and gum arabic, etching the portions of the stone that were not protected by the grease-based image. When the stone was subsequently moistened, these etched areas retained water, and oil-based ink could then be applied and would be repelled by the water, sticking only to the original drawing. The ink would finally be transferred to a blank paper sheet, producing a printed page. This traditional technique is still used in some fine art printmaking applications today. In modern lithography, the image is made of a polymer coating applied to a flexible plastic or metal plate. The image can be printed directly from the plate, the orientation of the image is reversed, or it can be offset by transferring the image onto a flexible sheet, rubber, for printing and publication. Now that I've burnished it and smoothened out the paper fills, I'm using a water-reversible gouache to put down a tone in these areas. After the tone is put down there, I'll refine it with either markers or watercolor pencils to make it blend in to the background. All of our materials used are water-reversible and archival. Lithography uses simple chemical processes to create an image. For instance, the positive part of an image is a water-repelling substance, while the negative image would be a water-retaining substance. Thus, when the plate is introduced to a compatible printing ink and water mixture, the ink will adhere to the positive image and the water will clean the negative image. This allows a flat print plate to be used, enabling much longer and more detailed print runs than the older physical methods of printing, as in letterpress printing, or intaglio printing. Lithography was invented in the Kingdom of Bavaria. In the early days of lithography, a smooth piece of limestone was used, hence the name lithography. After the oil-based image was put on the surface, a solution of gum arabic in water was applied, the gum sticking only to the non-oily surface. During printing, water adhered to the gum arabic surfaces and was repelled by the oily parts, while the oily ink used for printing did the opposite. In the early days of lithography, oftentimes the artist himself made the plates, did the artwork on the plates, and made the color combinations himself. As time went on in the printing field, standards and practices separated the duties of the lithographer from that of the artist. So it's hard to know with many of these posters whether the artist himself did the plates or whether a lithographer did them. Most likely, a union lithographer interpreted the artwork onto the plates. I'm using watercolor to create a tone over the paper pulp to match it with the rest of the poster. This is a water reversible process. In my 37 plus years in restoring vintage posters, especially circus posters and magic posters, I've never seen this poster or have heard of this particular act before, leading me to believe that this poster may be extremely rare and valuable among collectors of this ilk of performance posters, which I put into the circus poster category because oftentimes these kind of acts were parts of circuses, although not necessarily. They could have been part of another kind of live variety show. So it's a very unusual and exciting lithograph in terms of its rich color, draftsmanship, strong design, strong drawing, and the fact that it's of this act. There's very little evidence left of their act to know about them. There are photographs, there are articles written about them, but here is a real authentic artifact of the Crotton brothers at Poster Fix.
And now I'm going back into the poster with watercolor pencils to fine-tune bits and pieces, little scratches and nicks here and there. You're probably wondering, is a Poster Fix compatible with archival standards and practices? A process that is accepted as a means of preserving a vintage poster? And the answer is generally yes. Generally, because most collectors, auction houses, museums, and so forth, respect and acknowledge the benefits of linen backing, provided it is archival linen backing. There are some areas of archiving old paper ephemera where linen backing may not be chosen as the option for preservation. There are other means to preserve vintage paper. However, those means are not always practical to the everyday collector and displayer of vintage posters.
I think it's time to eat lunch. I've been working on this too long.
We'll be right back.
We are back in the Poster Fix shop and we are getting into the home stretch. We are almost finished with this vintage poster. All I have to do now is touch up the borders and do a few finishing touches. Thank you.
think I've got 99% of the touch-up completed, maybe 90%, 95%. I'm going to trim it down now and straighten the edges, and then look it over carefully and give it some last finishing touches. But this will not occur until later this evening. For now, I'm going to clean up this area to get it ready for tonight.
Well, that about wraps it up for today's edition of Poster Fix. I hope you enjoyed our video. If you haven't subscribed already, please do so and hit the notification bell so that YouTube informs you of whenever we have a new video on YouTube, which is about once a week, sometimes twice a week. I look forward to seeing what posters you're going to send me. And remember, at Poster Fix, we love to bring your vintage posters back to life.